The brand of straighteners that I'm using is Aria Beauty. They are infrared straighteners, which means they heat your hair from the inside out opposed to the outside in. So it's meant to protect the outer layer of your hair and give a real nice sheen. They have a gauge where you can put the temperature up or down. And I bought these straighteners last year in the sales. It was on Boxing Day sales. They were £300, but I got 50% off, so I got them for £150. And I can truly say they are really good straighteners. I've got 4B type hair, and whenever I straighten my hair, I just give one swipe and it gets it real straight. So I would really recommend these straighteners. The secret of silk pressing your hair, you really have to do small sections. So take your time and only part a slight bit of hair and then straighten it, and also make sure all the knots are out. I don't do the chase method. I don't feel like I need to. I just comb it, make sure the knots are out, and then I give it one swipe and it gets it bone straight. And these straighteners give a real nice sheen to the hair. Over the years, I've also learned it's best to put nothing in your hair when you're about to straighten it. Make sure you straighten your hair on clean hair and make sure you've had a treatment. So before I straightened my hair has been washed, it's been treated, and I just put on a little bit of conditioner, and that is it. Back in the day, I used to put in oils, but now I've learned that if you put nothing in your hair, it just doesn't get weighed down by the oils and it makes it lightweight and flyaway. And you may notice a lot of the times when you straighten your hair, you'll see a lot of smoke coming from the straighteners. I mean, you can see in this video there's still slight smoke coming, but not as much, because the more product you have in your hair, the more likely it is to burn. So I literally just have a bit of conditioner, and that is it, and it just gets it really nice and light and flyaway. It's hard to say how long my hair stays straight for, because I do go gym 4 days a week, so I've never actually straightened my hair and not been to the gym. So with me going to the gym 4 days a week, I'd say my hair lasts about straight about a week and a half, and it just starts to get puffy at the roots at that stage. The front of my hair is a lot softer. The front and midsection of my hair is a lot softer than the back. So the back will always revert first, and also the roots, because obviously that's where I'm sweating. But I haven't actually tested my hair to see how long it would last without me getting all sweaty. But the lady who sold me the straighteners told me that my hair would stay straight until I wash it. But when she said that, I was thinking, yeah, right. It was an Asian lady, and I just thought, you know, my hair is different from your hair, so I didn't really trust her on that one. But she did sell me these straighteners. I never thought I'd spend so much money on straighteners, but I have to say, they are really worth it. So after straightening, I'm just going over the ends a little bit, because my ends are due for a trim, so they're a little bit split, and I have a few single strand knots, so just lightly going over the ends a bit more. Now I am using my protective heat protectant serum. I know you're probably thinking I'm working backwards, but as I said, I don't like to put anything on my hair beforehand, and I just put a tiny bit of this in just for a little bit of sheen. And as you can see, look how lightweight it is. It's just flyaway, and that's how your hair should look once you straightened it. You don't want it to look all stiff and caked down. It's supposed to look like this. Always want you to. You got to do more than just. You got to do less when you tell mommy you know I. See, you gonna need to do more than just. Going to bump my hair. You don't have to do this if you don't want to, but if you bump your hair, it gives it more body and just makes it look a bit more voluptuous. And I got taught to bump my hair like a couple months ago. Before that, I did not know how to do it, but for those of you who are new subscribers, I used to have dreadlocks for about 16 years. So it's been about 18 months now since I cut my dreads off. So all of this is still new to me. I'm still learning how to do certain things. So I'm just going to bump my hair. And yeah, as I said, it makes it look more full and more voluptuous. But if you want to just leave it straight, it still looks nice straight. I wasn't too sure if I should bump it because I feel like bumping my hair makes me a bit older. But yeah. Now I'm going to attempt to wrap my hair. Now, I cannot wrap my hair to save my life. I wasn't going to film this part, but I want to show the truth. I want to show that sometimes it is a struggle to do certain things. So, here's me attempting to wrap my hair. I need to learn, I need to get on YouTube and practice a bit more. I have seen a few videos and you girls make it look so damn easy, and I hate when things look so easy but it's so hard for me to do. So you'll see I speed up when I finally get to do it in the end, and yeah. I find it a lot easier when I put bobby pins sort of like section by section, but I find bobby pins leave kinks in my hair, so I also don't like to use that. So I know you can do it without bobby pins as well, but I just don't know how to do it. But even if you can't wrap your hair like me, like even if you can do it just rubbish, roughly, when you go to bed at night, still wrap it, because it makes a real big difference in the morning. And it's just a good, if you, when your hair's straight, it's just a good way to keep your hair when you go to sleep. Wrap it and put a headscarf on it quickly before it falls down. And yeah, your hair will be stay really sleek. So now I am wrapping my hair in some cling film. So we are doing a silk press. So this is part of the stage. It's part of one of the stages of silk pressing. So you're gonna wrap it in cling film, and then I'm gonna put on my portable hair bonnet, and I love this. I bought it from Amazon. I'll try and leave a link for you in the description box. If you don't know about these hair dryers, it's really, really good. It's basically just a portable hair dryer, and I sat under here for about 20 minutes. To be honest with you, you don't really need to do this stage. I mean, it depends on your hair type, but for me, I didn't really see a massive difference in doing this stage. So just see what works for you. And yeah, so you just take down the cling film after about 20 minutes and you'll see my hair looks so healthy, shiny, look at the bounce. And I'm just gonna brush it out. And yeah, I recently dyed my hair for the first time since I cut my dreads off as well, so I will be doing a video on that, so stay tuned for that one. I love the way my hair is looking so dark and healthy right now. And here's me trying to do a sexy slow mode, or should I say fast mode. But yeah, this is the end result, and I really do love it. And here's the back, and hey, check that length. I think I need to do a length check. My hair's grown so much since I cut my dreads. And I'm just using my favourite edge control, Kira Kira, to slay them edges to the gods. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I hope you have a lovely day. Bye. She say to keep on playing games. The love is not the same. I don't know what to say, but what a shame. You a mind and your style is to blame. You a queen and your crown never change. Got your own but deserve everything. Got a nigga hooked, baby, no cocaine. Head 100, baby, can I be frank? Got a million women trying to get in my life. But you the only one got me feeling this way. Got a nigga feeling like I'd rather do it out those same old